Welcome back to another fun and exciting experiment here on Playing with Rain. Today we're actually going to make some colorful milk and actually see kind of a magical experiment with that milk. The materials you'll need for this experiment is a white plate that you can put the milk on. You'll want to have a couple different varieties of milk. I have skim milk and whole milk. You can try it with 2% as well. Some food coloring, some dish soap, and a couple of cotton swabs. First, we're going to get whatever type of milk you want to start with. I'm going to go ahead and start with the skim milk. And this is just to kind of get a variety of different reactions to see what happens. So I'm going to pour a little bit of skim milk onto my plate. Carefully, you don't want to spill anything, of course. And that's plenty. Set that back down there. And once you've poured your milk into your plate, you're going to want to pull out your food coloring. I have some blue, red, green, and some yellow. And you just want to put a drop or two of each color into the middle of your plate of milk. So there's a little yellow, here's some green, some blue in there, and some red. Okay, now the trick to this, you kind of have a big blob in the middle of your plate of some colored milk now. We're gonna put a little bit of dish soap onto this cotton swab. So I'm just gonna pour a little drop. You don't want a whole lot of it. Kind of stick it right there at the top, put some soap on there, and you're going to take this drop of soap on this cotton swab and put it right in the middle of your plate. Now, this is the cool part. Pay attention to this right here. Whoa. Look at that. And you can actually release the cotton swab, and the reaction basically stops. And as soon as I put it back into the water, it starts to expand again. All of those molecules start to bounce off. The soap is interacting with the milk, and it's actually interacting with the fat molecules in the milk. And they don't really like each other, so they start bouncing off. As that happens, it starts to push that food coloring in different directions. So you can notice that. And it's really cool to just kind of see the outline you saw from the inside and then working its way outward. That soap, once it interacted with the milk, started to push those molecules around. And because the food coloring was right there sitting in the milk, it just kind of got pushed all around. You're able to see that reaction happen pretty quickly. It's still kind of happening, but as I put this back in, that reaction does start to slow down just a little bit. Eventually, once all of those molecules have kind of gotten to their resting point where they want to be, they're going to kind of just sit there and it's not going to do much any longer. But because this has to do with the way that the soap molecules interact with the fat molecules in the milk, something interesting I want to try is doing a different fat content of milk. So skim milk, of course, has a lot lower fat content. I have whole milk that has a lot more fat content in it. So we're gonna go ahead and clean this plate off and we're gonna go ahead and try it again with some whole milk. Okay, now that we have cleared off the skim milk that we used for the first part of this experiment, we are now going to grab our whole milk and we're going to do the same thing. We'll just pour a little bit onto the plate. Very carefully, trying not to spill if we can. Don't wanna cry over spilled milk, but hopefully we don't spill anything. Now, we are going to put a couple drops of each coloring, food coloring in here. Blue, let's do some yellow. And notice this time I am deciding to not drop them all right on top of the same colors in the middle, but still putting them in the middle, but just kind of in their own respective spots so that they don't become all of one color. We want to kind of see more of a swirl this time as well. That's just another variation you can use with this. Now, I am going to put a little soap on this cotton swab, and you do want to be careful. I've actually done this many times where I've been putting it over the top of the milk when I do this, and a drop will hit the side of the milk and it'll mess it up. So just be careful of that. You want to put it on top. I dripped a little bit on the table, but that's okay. That's better than on the plate. And then we're going to put this right back to the middle. Let's see what happens. Remember, this is with whole milk that has a higher fat content than skim milk. Wow, look at that. Look how quick that reaction happens as those molecules start to bounce off of each other again. And it's so cool. You can kind of move this around, make a little bit of a rainbow. There's yellows and reds mixing in, the blues. And something that I think is kind of cool about doing this experiment is every time you do it, you get a slightly different reaction. Your pattern's going to be different. This one kind of looks a little bit like a star. The last one kind of looked like a star a pattern as well. But I did it with my kids before, just kind of practicing this. And it did all sorts of different shapes and swirls. And it's just kind of cool. You never quite know exactly what you're going to get. But the more fat content you have, you tend to have a better reaction. The skim milk was still pretty impressive, but I do think that the whole milk wins the award for showing us just the most dramatic effect with that. If you want to learn more about the science behind this, kind of the in-depth science behind this experiment, please check out our website, playingwithrain.com. I go into a little bit more detail about the science on these experiments there. If you did enjoy this experiment, which I hope you did, please don't forget to like and also hit that subscribe button so that you can see all the other experiments headed your way. If you have any other experiments you'd like to see us try or any feedback, you can comment below. You can also find us on social media. Once again, thanks again, and we'll see you next time.